Introducing Portfolio Review Pro, your ultimate solution for effortless mutual fund analysis. Begin by logging in to primeinvestor.in/portfolioreviewpro. As a new user, you will first be directed to our landing page, where you have a lot of details about this tool. I'll be guiding you through all of this in this video entirely. Though this is a free tool, you'll need to be a registered user on our platform to use it. The registration process is pretty simple. You can either choose a classic way by entering your name and email, or my favorite, Google sign-up based registration with just a single click. Once you're in, a free account for 14 days is already created with your Google email, which gives you access to this tool and a whole bunch of other tools on stocks, bonds, NPS, FDs and more for about 2 weeks. Just enter your PAN and mobile number and click start review. You'll get a pop-up requesting for an OTP. This should generally come to your mobile in a few seconds from MF Central. As you know, even today, many other market players use the CAS CSP uploads for getting your portfolio and starting the review. We feel it's more of a hurdle. We've done away with all of that to make this process very user-friendly. Based on your portfolio, this process might take a little bit long for some of you, but in most cases, it should be done in about half a minute. Once you're in, you'll first see the summary page with your name and PAN number displayed, and your overall holdings current value, your invested amount, your gains and losses, and even your entire portfolio's XIRR. Every corner of your mutual fund investment is carefully grouped here under equity, debt, and others. Even your hybrid funds are separated at a portfolio level and added to respective equity and debt sections to give you a clear asset allocation picture. You also have market cap details of stocks under equity. You also have top 10 stocks you have exposure to based on your MF investments. Even the top 10 sectors. Likewise, in debt, you will have credit quality of debt instruments, how much weight you have in each of those instruments, and things like that. This is the review section. I'll circle back here in a bit. Quickly, this section below, we will have a list of all the funds you hold right now. This is a comprehensive list gathered from all your investment sources. It could be multiple brokers, accounts, and so on. We have here our prime ratings and also this orange thumbs up which says whether it's a prime fund or not. Prime funds is our recommended list of funds. You'll also see your current value in each and even returns. You can swap between XIRR and absolute returns using this tab. See, we built this tool to be an advanced and a more customizable review tool, but some of you would like to use this even as a simple tracking tool. So, we've added a lot of sort and filter options to give you more flexibility to play with. Lastly, if you need to know more details on a specific fund that you hold, you can just click on the fund and it'll open up in a new page with more details such as rolling returns, SIP returns, etc. Do note, this is more of a general information on the fund and not your investment in the fund. To see fund-specific details, we need to go to the review page. Now let's get there. This page here is an intermediate page before the actual review page. If you see investment reviews in general, more than it being good or bad, knowing if it is right or not for your time frame and your risk level is something very important. That is a very unique feature of this tool because this tool gives you a flexibility to choose all funds and a subset of your funds. Now, why would we do that? We'll all have different funds for different goals. This set is for retirement, this fund is for buying a car, and so on. Our tool gives you the ability to select just that portfolio and select a suitable risk level and time frame for that specific goal and go review that portfolio. Here I'm going to choose the age, risk and time frame and pick a few funds to show you a sample of how the final review will actually look like. Clicking on review, this is the review page. At the top, you will see this score which is your portfolio's health score. This will give you a quick idea of how your portfolio is doing. You can even share this scorecard on Twitter and see what your other friends score on their portfolios. Below this, you will have the total value of your investments and total current value of the portfolio, asset allocation, just the same way how we saw back in the summary page, etc. Below this, we have performance, risk, quality, concentration, and expense ratio. These are the five different points on which we review your portfolio. In performance, we group the underperforming funds in your portfolio based on each category, where we'll be seeing if that particular fund is underperforming the category average on a 3-year rolling return basis. Under risk, if you see, this is basically divided into two sections. The first section is where we compare the portfolio's asset allocation for the declared time frame and risk. If it does not match, then we'll tell you how risky your portfolio is and also give you an ideal asset allocation for your time frame. In the next section, we have arranged the funds in your portfolio in the order of risk from high to low. You can read more about the risk section in the guide link given here. We've even given a quick legend for you to easily understand which of the funds you hold are more riskier and which ones are lesser. Under the quality section, you will find our research team's buy, sell, hold calls. You will know how much weight you have in each of these funds so that you could easily take your own call on whether holding it or selling it. Next part, concentration. We will tell you if you have too many funds or too few funds in your portfolio based on your overall portfolio size. It even tells you if you have too much weight on a single fund or just a few funds or even high concentration to a single AMC. Lastly, under expense ratio, you will find a list of funds that are having high expense ratio. Yes, regular funds are usually higher in expense than the direct funds, but we just don't tell you that regular funds are higher in expense. We alert you only if your regular fund is charging much higher than the category. Like in this case, usually the sector fund's expense ratio difference between the regular and direct is about 1.2%. But this fund's difference is much higher, hence we have added it to the list. You also have an option to download this entire review as a PDF. We hope this tool helps you to shape your portfolio better and make the fund review process a lot more simpler. Do share your thoughts and feedback using this link below. That's it from us for now. Try our Portfolio Review Pro today.
Investment in securities market are subject to market risks. Read all the related documents carefully before investing.